pain, for the former things have passed away. Won't it be wonderful there? Ooh, and with the Savior we enter the glory land. Won't it be wonderful there? Ending the troubles and hands on the story land. Won't it be wonderful then? Ooh, won't it be wonderful then? Having no burdens to bear, ooh, I'm there. Joylessly singing with heart bells ringing. Oh, won't it be wonderful then? Oh, walking and talking with Christ the Supernal One. Won't it be wonderful then? Praising, adoring the matchless Eternal One. Won't it be wonderful then? Oh, won't it be wonderful then? Having no burdens to bear over there, joylessly singing with heart bells ringing. Oh, won't it be wonderful then? There where the tempest will never be sweeping, won't it be wonderful then? Sure that forever the Lord will be keeping. Won't it be wonderful then? Oh, won't it be wonderful then? Having no burdens to bear over there, joyously singing with heart bells ringing. Oh, won't it be wonderful then? Oh, won't it be wonderful, wonderful? Burdens to bear over there, joyously singing with heart bells all ringing. Won't it be wonderful, wonderful there?
Amen. Amen. This is wonderful that the Lord has blessed us to see this another day.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Just to get to the place, just don't take that for granted anymore.
Amen.
Each and every day, I just say thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Just keep on moving, and if He blessed me to see tomorrow, then you know I'm happy. It is well with my soul. Amen. 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 Just a few minutes. Let's sing a verse of 646. Help me sing it. Sing it like you mean it. I believe that in prayer, just a little talk with Jesus, I believe it makes everything all right. It makes all the difference in the world.
Talk to it.
I was lost in sin,
but Jesus took me in, and then the light from heaven filled my soul. Oh, it made my heart in love, and wrote my name above. Just a little talk with Jesus makes it right. Let us
have a little talk with Jesus.
Let us
tell him all about our trouble.
He will give and we will answer by. And when you feel prayerful, as your heart is turned, you will find a little talk with Jesus. Makes it right. Makes it right. Eyes be filled with tears, but Jesus is a friend who watches day and night. I'll go to Him in prayer. Oh Lord, He knows my every care, and just a little talk with Jesus makes me cry. Now let us have a little talk with Jesus. Let us tell Him all about our trouble.
He will hear and he will answer by and by. Now when you feel the prayerful as your heart ever is turned, you will find a little talk with Jesus makes it right.
Amen. Amen. Matthew chapter 7, verses number 13 and 14.
Come to us.
Jesus said, Enter ye in at the straight gate. For wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction.
That's it.
And many there be which go in thereat.
Mercy.
Because straight is the gate.
Straight gate.
And narrow is the way which leadeth unto life,
and few
there be that find. We want to talk for a few minutes about where will you end up.
Amen.
Where will you end up? You see, life is described as a brief pause between two eternities.
All right.
You will spend eternity in one place or the other.
Amen. That's it.
And it depends on the decision that you make and the choices that you choose and the road you choose to travel.
Amen.
Where you're going to end up.
Each road.
Has a final destination.
That's right.
See?
Mm-hmm.
Now, if I want to go to New York,
all right,
there's no way I'm going to get there if I'm going to take stuff I-65.
Amen.
Ain't going to make it.
That's right.
It's going to be a long trip. And I'm eventually end up in Ocean somewhere. You just can't get there.
Yeah.
Travel south 65. You can't get there. That's the point.
Amen.
You can't get there on 65 south.
That's right.
Now you catch a plane and go north and all that stuff, you'll make it to New York.
Yeah.
But you ain't get there on South 65.
Thank you. That's it.
It's gonna run out.
That's it.
And you'll end up down there in Mississippi and the devil.
Amen.
Delta. Yeah. You know, I can't get to California if I'm going to head east to here.
That's right.
End up in Washington, D.C., South Carolina, North Carolina.
Yeah. That's right.
End up in the ocean. There's a certain road you have to get on.
That's right.
If I'm going to New York.
Make it plain.
Certain direction I have to travel.
That's right. Real plain.
East. If I'm going to California.
That's right.
And you know, in this life, from the time we are born, we are surrounded by death from the day we are born.
Amen.
Bible says, Job said, you know, man is born of a woman
in
a few days. And full of trouble. Every time we turn around, somebody's dying.
Lord have mercy.
James said, now what is your life that is pierced for a little while?
Yes.
And vanishes away. People say now that there are many directions that you can take in life, but I want you to understand that's what people say, and I understand what they're trying to say, but Jesus said there's only two ways.
That's right. Amen.
Only two ways. You know, Jesus said, now, there is a broad way and a narrow way.
Amen.
One leads to destruction.
Yes.
The other
leads
to life. Mm. That broad way comes from a phrase or a word that has to do with something that is spacious and wide open.
That's right.
And what the message is that you can travel this way or this road and you head in this direction, but destruction will be the outcome.
All right.
Because the broad way suggests that anything goes.
Amen.
Amen.
On the broad way.
Yeah.
He said you can bring whatever you want.
That's right.
On the broad way.
Yeah. Right. Yes. Whatever.
You can make your own rules on the broad way.
Amen. Yeah.
What's wrong now?
You don't have to listen to nobody.
That's right.
On the broad way.
Do your own.
See?
Yes.
They've been saying that a long time. We was young. We said it was doing your own thing. I forgot what y'all call it now, but it's the same thing.
Same thing.
But it leads to the destruction.
Right.
On the broad way, you know, Satan makes the rules. He convinced you he's in charge. Satan convinced you that you are in charge, is what I'm trying to say.
All right.
But when you call the shot, when you're a king on a throne, the broad way leads toward destruction.
So true. Yes.
And it's not what, and not only the Bible says it, this destruction is portrayed and is lived out every day in your life.
Amen. Amen.
You can look at this country, you can look at this world, and what's going on, and you can see the destruction and the misery that is going on is because people has chosen the broad way.
Amen. Preach it. Preach it.
And they haven't even reached their final destination yet. And you must understand when you look at our community, all of the destruction in our community. See? We need to quit putting it on the white man.
Amen.
The problem is the broad way.
Amen. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Preaching.
You headed down the broad way that Jesus talked about.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Preaching.
Help us.
You must understand that when you're on the broad way, you are not in control when you're on the broad way.
That's right.
Turn with me to Ephesians chapter 2. Help me out, y'all.
Gotcha.
Ephesians chapter 2.
Gotcha.
All notice right. What Paul says here about the broad way.
About the broad way.
See? The Bible said, now Paul said, Ephesians chapter 2. And you are
hath he quickened.
Who
were dead in trespasses and sins.
Trespasses and sins. Now stop right there.
All right.
Now let's look at this for a little while. Now he said you have been quickened. Quickened means made alive.
Made alive.
And you were made alive by Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Because you were dead in trespasses and sin.
That's right.
See? And the wages of sin is death.
Yeah.
You was made alive, you was quickened by Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So true.
While we were yet sinners,
Christ
died for the ungodly.
All right.
See, Christ did something for ourselves, for us that we could not do ourselves.
Amen.
If we could have saved ourselves,
there's been no need for him to die.
That's right.
Amen.
Preach it.
But ye have he quickened, made alive, because we were dead in trespasses and sin. See, we were on the path of destruction. We were living on this broad way.
Amen.
We were traveling down the broad way.
Yes.
See that? He was, agree, Jeremy,
wherein in time past
you walked
according to the course of this world.
Yes.
According to the prince of the power of the air.
Yes.
The spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience.
The spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience. See, you ain't even being controlled. Somebody's controlling you.
Mm.
See that? The spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience. See? You on the broad road. You think you making your shots. You ain't doing nothing being led by this
Amen.
Spirit. This spirit is Satan.
Amen.
The spirit that now what? Worketh in the children of disobedience. When you being disobedient to God, this spirit is working in you. You ain't even in the control.
Man.
And verse 3 says,
Among whom also we all had our conversation in time past.
Yes.
In the lust of our flesh.
Yes, of the flesh.
Fulfilling the desires of the flesh.
Yes.
And of the mind.
Of the mind.
And were by nature
the
children of wrath.
Children of wrath.
Even as others.
You ain't in control. Satan's working his himself all in you and through you. And in this world. See that?
Amen.
Leading to destruction, the broad way. But then in next verse says,
But God.
We was on this broad way, this destruction, but God.
But God.
See? But God,
who is rich in mercy,
for his great love,
wherewith he loved us.
But God so loved the world, and that was it.
He gave his only begotten Son,
that whosoever should believe in him should not perish, but shall have everlasting life. But God, see that?
But God.
We on this road of destruction.
Amen.
And as you look at our communities, and let me tell you something. In Proverbs, go over there with me. I think it's Proverbs 13. Bear with me, I'm a little slow. Proverbs 13. If you find it, before I find it, it's all right. Go ahead and read. Proverbs 13. And I'm on verses 14 and 15. Mm-hmm. You got it, Brother Jim?
Whosoever despises the word shall be destroyed.
Okay, all right. Proverbs 13, verses 14 and 15.
All right. The law of the wise.
I want y'all to listen to it.
The law of the wise is a fountain of life.
Oh, stop. The law of the wise is what?
A fountain of life.
Man, if you want life, you talk about the word of God.
That's right.
It's the fountain of life. This eternal life is in his Son. Go ahead, Brother Jerry.
Good understanding.
No, wait a
minute. Okay. Depart from the snares of death.
Isn't that so?
To depart from the snares of death.
Isn't
that so? The law of the wise is a fountain of life.
Yeah.
To depart from the snares of the death.
Isn't that so? Man, you got to stick with Jesus. You got to stick with God. You got to stick with the word. If you want to depart from the snares of death, man, Satan is always trying to snare us. We wrestle not against what? Flesh and blood, isn't that right? But against principalities, he's always trying to snare us.
Thank you.
See that? But go ahead on. Verse 15 says, "No what?
Good understanding, giveth favor,
yeah.
But the way of transgressor is hard."
You wonder why things are so rough for you. Quit sin.
Yeah.
How about that? You know, when you make the wrong decision in life, and you complain about how hard it is, you need to think about the decision that you made.
All right. Amen.
And let me tell you this. Now, y'all always talking about, Brother Jerry, always talking about education. Well, let me tell you something. If you don't have sense enough to go sit up in school and get your work and graduate and go on and get your degree and make some good choices, don't be talking about the white man is against you because you can't find a job.
All right, amen.
You don't know nothing.
Amen.
Is that right?
Amen.
You ain't got no diploma.
Amen.
And nowadays, a high school diploma is just a starting point.
That's it.
There was a time when I was coming along and Brother Jerry and all of us coming along. Let me tell you something, you didn't need a diploma. If you didn't graduate, you could go on out there and GE. There's a whole lot of places where you make a lot of money. You can run on over to Philip Mars. You can run out to Harvest. Ain't that right? Peter Law. Man, there's a million places in Louisville you can work.
Right.
And they'll work with your hand and take care of your family without a high school education.
That's right.
Now you can't even wrap bubble gum without high school education. Am I telling you right, Brother Jerry?
You're telling the right, brother.
You're telling it right. Tell it.
The choices that you make.
Tell it.
And the Bible said, you know, the way of the transgressor
is hard.
Let me tell you something. The Bible says now, marriage is honorable and all, Hebrew 4, 12, which one it is. Marriage is honorable and all, and the bed is undefiled, but the whole mother and adulterer, God will judge.
Amen. Hebrews 13, 5.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Judge. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Now, let me tell you something about that and all that sexual marriage. You know. Let me tell you something about having all them babies.
Mm-hmm. Preach
them. All that.
Preach it.
Now, the wake is hard when you have a baby.
All right.
And you ain't married.
Amen.
You know what? It's hard. You know, nowadays, sometimes, unless your husband or somebody, y'all got one of them real fancy jobs, pay just a whole lot of money, it takes two incomes in there, right?
That's right. Right. That's right.
There's two of them.
That's right.
See? Now, it's just one of you, and you done had one, and you done had another.
Preacher.
Now, tell me how you going to buy, you going to provide a house, food, education, you know, and you the only one working, you got two babies, and you ain't making number $12 an hour. That ain't going to get it.
Amen.
Is that right?
That's right.
The way of the transgressor is hard. And how you going to get back to school? You talking about, I got that, and you know, now you got to find some help for babysitters to go to work. After work, you got to find some babysitters to go to school.
Lord,
now the child ain't seeing his mama or nothing. Man, the way of the transgressor is hard. Am I telling the truth, bro?
Preach it.
Tell the truth. And the white man didn't make that baby. See how that baby
hangs?
Don't blame the white man.
Yeah.
No, it's you and Tyrone. See, the word of God is right. I ain't judging nobody. I ain't got no heaven in here. I'm going to be saved by grace just like you. But you know, the Bible tells me and Jerry and everybody, he said, now preach the word.
Preach it. Yes.
And when it gets me, I say, how do you do?
Love.
just got to tell the truth.
Yeah.
See?
Preach it.
But it's the broad, that broad way.
Amen. Oh. Yeah.
Jesus said there's two ways. See? Mm-hmm. And then he said the narrow way.
Yeah.
And it has to do with something being pressed and restricted. And see, that narrow way, you can't bring your sins along that narrow way.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
There is only one rule maker on the narrow way.
Amen.
See? And Jesus identified himself as that way.
As the way.
See?
Truth and the way.
Yes.
Yes.
He said, ye believe in God, believe what? Also in me. In my Father's house, there are many mansions. If it was not so, I would have told you. But he said, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare that place for you, I will come again to receive you unto myself, that where I am, ye may be also. He said, I am the way, the way. See that?
Amen.
That's right. He's that narrow way.
Amen.
He said, except you believe that I am he, you should die in your sins. And if you die in your sins, what I am, he cannot go.
Amen.
He may call the shots. He said, if you continue my word, then you are my disciples indeed. See? He is that way. He is that narrow way. You can't take your sins with you. Mm. And you have to follow the rule.
Mm. Yep.
Follow the rule. He says we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but all this present power. He said, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. See. On this narrow way, you have to really be willing to die to yourself.
Thank you. Thank you.
Paul said, I am what? Crucified with Christ.
Yeah.
See? It's no more about me and my way, but it's Christ living in me.
Thank you. See?
And then one day at the end of these ways, there's a final destination.
Yes.
You got heaven, and you got hell.
Amen.
See? Turn to Mark chapter 9 for just a few minutes. And notice what the Bible says about this hell. In Mark chapter 9, I think the one I'm looking for. Matthew, Mark. And verse number 43. Notice what it says.
And if thy hand offend thee.
Yes, what?
Cut it off.
Yes.
It is better.
Yes.
It is better for thee to enter into life maimed than having two hands to go into hell.
Yes.
Into the fire.
Yes.
That never shall be quenched.
Ah, isn't that something? Mm. Tells you something about priority. It says, it'd be better off for you to be running around here maimed than to end up in hell.
Amen.
See that? In other words, Jesus was saying, let me tell you don't want to go there. You know?
Amen.
It wasn't prepared for you anyway.
Amen.
It was prepared for the devil, then it wasn't. See? When Jesus said, I go to prepare a place for you, he had you in mind. But you got to make the choice if you want to go or not.
All right.
But you will go one place or the other.
Amen. Right.
But let me tell you a little bit about this place that if you choose the broad way. Or give me Luke chapter 16 for just a minute.
All right, please preach it.
Luke chapter 16. The Bible talks about Abraham and Lazarus. Y'all remember him?
That's right.
Verse 22 says, And it came to pass
that the beggar died
and was carried
by the angels into Abraham's bosom.
Yeah, the angels gonna come get all of us. But
the rich man also died
and was buried.
And was buried.
And what?
And in hell, he lifted up his eyes, being in torment, and seeth Abraham afar off, and Lazarus in his bosom.
Let me tell you something. When you go to hell, you're going to be conscious.
Amen.
And you're going to know what's going on.
Oh.
And you're going to know why you're there.
Yeah.
See that?
Yeah.
And it's a strange thing how we when we die, they take our bodies out there and put them in the grave, all right?
That's right.
These two men died, and they was put in the graveyard, right?
That's right.
But it says that after they have buried him, and in hell he lifted up his eyes,
being in torment.
You know what you can see after you die?
And seeth Abraham afar off. And Lazarus.
He's dead, right?
That's right. And Lazarus in his bosom.
And he's seeing somebody else, isn't it, right?
That's
you're
right.
Able to see where you are when you
die.
Amen.
Well, my eyeball's in the grave. Well, I ain't gonna argue with you about that. Jesus said you're still gonna be seen.
Amen.
All right. Flesh.
You're still gonna be able to see. And not only that, you know, he saw Lazarus and he cried and said, "What, Father Abraham?
Father Abraham, have mercy on me.
Send Lazarus.
Send Lazarus. That's right. That he may dip the tip of his finger in water."
Yes.
And cool my tongue.
For I am what?
For I am tormented in this flame.
Oh, boy.
There's
going to be some punishment going on.
Yes.
Now, let me ask you something. Now, is Tyrone worth all of this?
Amen. Lord, help me.
All right.
Oh, help.
Yes, sir.
Stay with me now.
Yes, sir.
Help him.
Help somebody.
Yeah.
Help him.
Is all them pills worth all of this?
All
that weed and all that stuff worth all of this? Because there's coming a reckoning time, people.
Lord, help us.
There's a reckoning time coming. See that? But Abraham said, "Son, remember that thou in my lifetime received what? Thou good thing.
Good thing.
And Lazarus, and likewise Lazarus, evil thing.
Evil thing. But now he is comforted, and thou art tormented.
And besides
all of this,
said Brother Jerry,
between us and you,
there
is a great gulf fixed,
so
that they which would pass from hence to you cannot, neither can they pass to us that would come from thence."
It's fixed. And then the next verse.
Then he said,
"Yeah.
I pray thee therefore,
Father,
that thou wouldest send him to my father's house. For I have five brethren, that he may testify unto them, lest they also come to this place of torment."
And I want to get this. Go ahead and finish reading that.
Abraham said unto him, "They have Moses and the prophets. Let them hear them."
Go ahead.
And he said, "Nay, Father Abraham, if one went up unto them from the dead, they will repent." And he said unto him, "If they hear not Moses and the prophets, neither will they be persuaded, though one rose from the dead."
All right. Now let me make this short run and then we need to about this way, this destination. Now he's down there suffering. Isn't that right?
That's right.
Now he wants to go back. I sent somebody back to his brothers. Let me tell you, once you're dead and you die like you are on that wrong way, if you get to, it's too late after that.
That's right. That's it.
To decide you're going to do the right thing now.
Yeah.
Too late. Too late for any remorse now.
Yeah.
too late for all of that, you know, now I see things clear. Now he sees things a whole lot clearer now than he ever did before.
Yeah. Amen.
See that? They've been trying to tell him all his life. But you know he's in charge. The lust of the flesh. Yeah. You ain't got time for church because there's too many hypocrites, you know, in church. But now you down there with all the rest of the hypocrites.
Yeah.
How about that?
Make it plain.
Yeah, now you down there with everybody.
Oh, got it. Got it.
And you know what? And he said, you know what? Somebody go tell my brothers and sisters, don't come to this place.
Lord,
tell my family, do not come to this place. It's too late now.
Oh.
You know? It's too late now.
Mm-hmm.
See? But if they, he said they have Moses and prophets. But Lord, if they just have somebody to come back from the dead, they will repent and don't come to this place. No, that ain't gonna work. Let me tell you, I know that ain't gonna work. You remember those same folks that knew that Jesus raised Lazarus from the dead?
That's right.
Still turned around and killed him.
Amen.
How about that?
Mm-hmm.
That's right. Still called out, crucified and crucified.
Crucified. Okay.
They saw him raise Lazarus.
From the dead, sure did.
From the dead.
Saw it, yep.
But he said, it wraps up and said, they have Moses and the what?
Prophet.
The prophets. In other words, you got the word of God. That's all you're going to get.
Amen.
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 You know, it saved, it pleased God by the foolishness of preaching. That's all you're going to get now, is to preach the word. And if the people don't respond to the preached word, you can jump through all kind of hoops.
Amen.
Because the Bible, Paul said, I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the what? The power of God unto salvation.
That's it.
Yes, sir.
That's it.
You got the word of God.
Amen, brother. That's it.
And that's what's going to do it.
That's it. Preach it.
The Holy Spirit's going to preach that heart through that word.
Amen.
Preach the word.
Preach it. Preach the word.
And the same thing that happened on the day of Pentecost, the Bible said that Peter got to preaching, said y'all had crucified the Lord Jesus, and they said, what, men and brother, what have we done?
Amen.
What must we do? Isn't that right?
That's right.
Paul said, Peter said, what? To repent and be what? Baptized. And see, the Bible said, they that what? Gladly received the word.
Amen. Amen.
Were baptized, and it was added unto them 3,000 souls.
Preach it.
Brother and sister, you know, we slowly moving to our final destination. I mean,
mercy.
And if you ain't on the narrow way, you need to make that decision today. And if you're not a child of God, the only way you can get on that narrow way is you got to obey the gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. That's the only way you can get on the narrow way.
Amen.
See? And if you ain't on the narrow way to obey the gospel, then you are on the broad way because there's only two ways.
Thank you.
Let me just read one thing. I said I was going to close, didn't I? But I am going to close after this, okay? 2 Thessalonians. Chapter 1. See? Okay. Read one more time, Uncle Brother Jerry.
All right.
2 Thessalonians chapter 1.
See,
I'm approved to you. You got to obey that gospel in order to get on that narrow way. And if you ain't obey that gospel, you ain't on the narrow way. See now, 2 Thessalonians chapter 1. You with me, Brother Jerry?
I'm with you.
Number 7 through 9. Go ahead.
All right. It says, and to you.
Yeah.
Who are troubled, rest with us.
Rest with us.
When the Lord Jesus shall be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels.
In flaming fire.
Taking vengeance
on them
that know not God. And that obey not
The gospel
of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Taking vengeance on all those who know not God and that obey not the gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, The only way you can get on that straight way and that narrow way is to obey the gospel of what? Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And if you haven't obeyed the gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, you are on the wrong way. And he's coming back and taking vengeance on all those that know not God and obey not the gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. You need to get on the narrow way today.
That's right.
You need to hear his word.
Right,
thank you.
Yes, sir. Be buried in baptism. Lord, wipe away your sins.
That's it. That's it.
Add you to his body. And you own the. And then, you know what? You'll be on that straight and narrow path.
Amen.
With God and Jesus and the Holy Spirit to be guiding you. And then one day, he'll say, what? Well done.
Man.
Revelation says there is no more tears, no more pain,
yes,
no more sorrow.
That's it.
See? And that's the foundation, final destination you want to be. If you hear, you're subject to the invitation, when you come right in, you understand.
Who at my door is standing? I pay his shiny door in there. I entrance with him demanding.